New at noon, fire crews were called to an apartment fire in Buffalo. News 4's Emily Gugamis is live at Amherst in Delaware, where firefighters had their hands full this morning. Emily?
They definitely did, Nalina. Approximately 50 people live inside of this apartment complex, and I'm told that 4 people sustained injuries, one of those being a fire chief, but all are non-life threatening. And that's thanks to the quick thinking of some off-duty firefighters who just happened to be in the neighborhood that everyone made it out alive. Talk about the right place at the right time.
I saw the woman on the front lawn. I was coming down this way and carried her across with another guy to help me, and then I went up in.
Firefighters Jeff Kane and Bob Carnavelli were off duty and in the neighborhood of this apartment complex at Delaware and Amherst when they saw smoke.
Yeah, you're taking in the smoke, you know, from what we do, you know how much you can handle and what you can't.
We're firefighters, so whether we have our equipment or on duty or not, you gotta do what you gotta do.
Witnesses say a woman living in a second floor apartment jumped out the window in order to survive.
Had to move her from the front lawn across the street because it was no longer safe because the air conditioner had flames around it and it was bursting in the window.
Get a better chance with the drop than the fire.
The fire started just after 9:30.
I heard someone in the hallway yell fire. I walked out of my door. And the fireman threw me to safety.
I couldn't breathe, so I mean, I covered my mouth up and tried to crawl out, but it was just too much.
Adrianus Ritterhoff had to leave behind his cat.
Apprehensive, you know, I don't want to go up there and find out my best little critter's gone, you know.
Luckily, they were reunited shortly after the fire was out, and it may have just been another day for these firefighters, but for Jeff Kane's wife, Sarah, who was just along for the ride, it left her a little uneasy.
It was a little nerve-wracking. I have my 6-year-old in the car with me, and that was a little nerve-wracking. No equipment to go in, you know, into a building without any masks or tanks or anything.
And there is a city bus on hand right now just for the residents to have a place to come and sit down and hang out. The Red Cross showed up just a little while ago, and the Salvation Army is also on hand. I just spoke with the fire commissioner, and he tells me that this building was actually inspected 2 months ago and everything was up to code at the time. The damage is estimated at $225,000. Reporting live, Emily Gugamis, News 4 News.